Hi, I'm Michael Vallandigham, pastor of Del Norte Baptist Church, and this is the recap of Sunday's message. December of 2018, I ran a half marathon. It was my very first and my very last. About October, I had been training for several months and I was doing great. I was going beyond anything that I ever thought that I could. My pace was wonderful. It just felt good. I was running better than I'd ever ran in my life. And then the next few weeks, chaos happened. The weather got bad. I began running in rain or cold, and I was running early in the morning, late at night, and it just seemed like that there was something going on weather-wise every single run. And then towards the middle end of November, we went deer camping, and there just really wasn't a good place to run while I was there. And we left from there and went to Mountain Air, New Mexico to see family. And of course, as I've said before, there is no oxygen in Mountain Air. And so I was on pace. I was supposed to run my longest run before the half marathon while we were there. I believe it was about 11 miles. And I took off and I began to run, and I could tell real quick that this was not a good thing, but I was determined. I was gonna get through this. I had to get this run in. I needed to be able to take some time off before the race. And so I finished it, and man, I was about to completely pass out. The kids met me at the gate as I was coming back in, and they really thought that I was about to die. And man, it just threw me for a loop. And so then I did all the small things the next few weeks and kind of kept it easy. And on race day, everything that could go wrong seemed to go wrong. I woke up when I was supposed to and ate what I kind of planned on eating that morning. Not a whole lot. I don't like to eat a lot before I run, but thought I had enough in me, and grabbed the Skittles and filled my pockets and thought, man, we're good to go. And then the race was postponed because of a storm. And I don't remember, it was an hour and a half or 2 hours later before we finally started, which put me finishing well into lunchtime. And man, it was a hard race. I had been training in cold, frigid temperatures for the last several weeks. And man, when that storm passed, the sun came out, it got up into the 70s, and it was just hot and it was bearing down on me. I had a hip flexor that was bothering me, and man, it was all I could do. I wanted to stop a million times. But I didn't stop. I persevered through it. I struggled through it. I thought, man, I am going to get this. I'm going to finish. And I finally did. I crossed the finish line. I never stopped running, which I was pretty proud of, though my time was absolutely horrible. It was not something I was proud of. You know, there's a lot of struggles that we go through in this world. Many of you today are going through struggles that maybe I couldn't even comprehend that you're going through. And man, life is hard, and we go through all these struggles, but we have to run to the end. We got to continue. We got to go through this. That's what James is telling us in James chapter 1, is he's telling us we need to persevere. We need to go through it. We need to have joy as we go through it, because God is there to help us. And in John chapter 1 in verse 12, it says, "Blessed is the man who remains steadfast under trial, for when he has stood the test, he will receive the crown of life which God has promised to those who love him." So how we make it to the finish line matters. And we need to be running. We need to run in such a way that we can win. Paul told us in 1 Corinthians 9, "Do you not know that in a race all the runners run, but only one receives the prize? So run that you may obtain it." We need to continue to run with all that we have, and not just be trying to survive, not just to get through it, kind of like when I was on the race, I just wanted to get through it. No, we as believers need to run, understand that we have the power of God with us, and we can run in such a way that we can win. And he goes on to say in verse 14, he says, "But each person is tempted when he's lured and enticed by his own desire." What gets in the way of us running the race the way that we need to run? It is ourselves. We get in the way. It is our desires. It's the sinful nature that is in us that gets us off track and messes with our whole ability to achieve what it is that God is wanting us to achieve, to be able to go through the difficult days and do it with strength and power. And we need to be people that flee from the sexual temptation and from all the temptation of the sin that is around us that our earthly bodily desires want to go after. In Hebrews 12, verse 1, it says, "Therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us Also, lay aside every weight and sin which clings so closely, and let us run with the endurance the race that is set before us, looking to Jesus, the founder and the perfecter of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is seated at the right hand of the throne of God. See, we cannot thrive in the midst of struggle if we do not recognize that we have a responsibility and there is sin that is getting in our way. And those sins, he tells us in verse 15, has consequences. Then desire, when it is conceived, gives birth to sin, and sin, when it is fully grown, brings forth death. When I was a kid, I loved to play with firecrackers around 4th of July, and the black cats, the little, you know, they're loud, and we would take those and blow everything up that we could. But as we got a little bit older, you start taking a risk, and you begin to light that firecracker while you're holding it and throw it and try to get it when you threw it just to, you know, to explode in the air, and it was so much louder, and we just thought that was so much fun. But you know, as you're doing that, there's always that firecracker that has a really quick fuse, and you light it, and man, before you even have a chance to think, that thing is going off in your hand, and you get burned. See, there's consequences when you're doing something that's kind of dumb. And it, with our sin, when we give in to those sinful desires, no matter what it is that you struggle with, when that sin pops up, there is a consequence to it. But you know what? God is a God that gives us grace. His grace is that free gift that He gives us to help us through those difficult days. And in James 1:16 says, "Do not be deceived, my beloved brothers. Every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow due to change." You know, grace is the gift that He gives us that we do not deserve. And every good gift that we get in this world comes from God. And Jesus is the greatest gift. That Jesus, who is God, who stepped out of heaven to become man, to put on the flesh, to put on His creation. And yet He lived in this world and had the same struggles of this world, but He did it without sin. And yet He had to die on the cross for us. Not for His own sin, but He died for our sin. That is the greatest gift, the greatest grace that we could ever even imagine that has come from Jesus. See, the finish line is approaching quickly. And yes, the struggles of this world are real. And right now, as we go through a time of COVID, it is difficult. And we're all struggling through that. And there's a lot of things going on in this world that are just absolutely hard. But God gives us the grace to get through it. And to know that, yes, the finish line is approaching quickly. There's going to be a day for each of us as we stand before our God in judgment. But completing the race is not about being perfect. Completing the race is about being forgiven. And so it's not whether or not we can do it in our own power, that we can do it perfectly, but that by God and His grace, He's working through us, despite the circumstances going on around us, He's working through us to complete in us what He has started. And so I want to encourage you, surrender to Jesus. Surrender your life to God who loves you and cares for you and wants to help you through these times. And as you run the race that He's put before you. Run it with joy, run it with confidence, knowing that He is going to help you across that finish line. God bless you. Have a great day.